towns that are quaint and nice to visit, Bar Harbor is a beautiful place to stay. Very big tourist attraction, a lot of little gift shops and quaint little ocean themed things there. It's very nice. Freeport is over here somewhere, I think. Freeport. Another beautiful place to go. Just super Maine, you know. You think of what, you know, Maine is almost like Cape Cod-ish, but a little bit more. A little bit more calm. It's not like, it's not as touristy as Cape Cod, but it's very similar. Is another very, very popular spot. As you get down here, it's a little bit more populated. Kennebunkport is the famous vacation spot for the Bush family, President Bush Senior and Junior. So you can drive by the Bush House. It's a big mansion. Portland. I think the most populated city in the state, and it must be. This is probably the culture capital of Maine. There's several colleges there. Lots of young people live there. There's sports arenas, and you know, it's a very nice city. Some good restaurants as well. And some really good seafood. So, very nice area. And down here is the border of New Hampshire, where I am from. So yeah, that's a pretty good overview. Other than that, again, it's a very, very rural state. It's a mix, however, there's a big mix between kind of rural conservative people and liberal, you know, younger liberal people who live in Portland and on the, you know, this area. So it's a big mix. However, it is extremely white. Not many people of different ethnicities live in Maine. It's a lot of French Canadian people as well. So it's a big state, but there are some very, very nice spots in Maine. And so yeah, we'll move on to the next map. And in this map, I thought this was pretty cool. They have a bunch of different lighthouses, so we're just gonna go through the map and just read some of them, and maybe if you see a name that you like, you can write it down and maybe visit it someday if you ever visit Maine. And just as a side note, I don't think I've visited many of these. In fact, I probably haven't visited any. this isn't the entire coast, but this is just a small section right here. We also have Mount Desert Rock. So I think I got all of them there. And that was just another reason for you guys to check out the landscape, see the different islands, and to maybe look at some of the towns. So hope you enjoyed that. And finally, our last map. I gotta do a historical map in every video. I found this one of Portland, Maine. And the date of the map is 1876. And I just really, really like this. If I could have this framed and just put on my wall, I could spend all day looking at all the little houses and stuff. And I don't know, it's just cool to me. Just to get that kind of bird's eye view. This is the harbor here, and you know, these days this is like the main drag, and there are restaurants and lots of different joints with good seafood. And I think over this way there is Sea Dogs, which is a like AA baseball team stadium there. There's also hockey arena around here. There's also another, I think that's, there's another arena where they have shows and stuff. So I don't know, I figured I'd let you guys just kind of peruse the map and maybe we can look down here. They have a bunch of numbers. I'm not going to go through all of it, but yeah, so that's been a nice little overview of Maine. And I hope you enjoyed it. Hope you learned maybe a little bit. My knowledge of Maine isn't extensive, but hopefully I've added a little bit of personal information to give you a feel of what Maine is like. If you want to visit, I would definitely recommend going to the seacoast. Acadia National Park is right over here, one of the most beautiful places I've ever been.